This is the SAP Developer News for May 8th, 2025.
So, the community is still excelling in collaboration and producing top quality code and content. Here is a recent example from Marianne Zeiss. Now, it involves the UI5 spreadsheet importer, which we've covered on previous news items on this show. But this time it also involves a CDS plugin for the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, which means it's now possible to upload and bypass the routing of data, the mass data through the front end and all the subsequent OData calls and the processing involved, and upload directly to a CAP backend. The CDS plugin was originally written by Wouter Lemaire, another friend of the community. And it allows this direct import to a CAP backend without all that tedious mucking about in hyperspace and frontend. Of course, that was a reference to the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, if you didn't recognize that already. With the latest release, that's 2.1.0, of the UI5 spreadsheet importer, you can now enable the use of this CDS plugin and upload with no code required on the frontend to change. Pretty neat. Anyway, Marianne's blog post has all the details. Check it out. Link in the description.
Have you heard about the Knowledge Graph engine in SAP HANA Cloud? It came as the new functionality in QRC 1 this year. Now, our COE in the US prepared a discovery mission for you, where you can go through a series of exercises and ready-to-use code to discover what KGE is, how you use the graph transformers to convert unstructured data into the triples and store them in SAP HANA Cloud, or how to turn structured data into the ontology that you can use in your AI applications. Check this out. I just finished this discovery mission and I learned quite a few things myself. There are some other AI capabilities that were delivered during recent couple of months, and to be able to give you some more exercises, I created the new CodeGem topic that is called AI Application Fundamentals with SAP HANA Cloud. We are planning to have such a CodeGem as well after the HANA TechCon. So if you are attending this event in Waldorf in Germany in July, then please check this event and decide if you want to join this SAP CodeGem, where we are going to go through all this new exciting AI functionality in SAP HANA. See you there.
Hey y'all, for all you front-end nerds out there, the May 2025 edition of the SAP Fiori Development Newsletter is now live, and it's packed with insights you don't want to miss. This issue covers cutting-edge updates to SAP UI5, including new tools and features to streamline your development process. There's all kinds of different updates over a variety of different topics, with links going into further detail. So there's a little something for everyone. One of my big bucket list items is visiting all 7 continents, and a bit of news that I found really interesting in this issue is that it turns out SAP UI5 has already beat me to it. It's on all 7 continents, including Antarctica, and it's crazy to think about how truly global SAP UI5 is. If that interested you as well and you want to learn more, or you just want to stay ahead of the curve and discover how SAP Fiori is shaping the future of development, head over to the SAP community page to check it out now. The issue is linked below, and as always, happy coding!
So before we end this news episode, we just wanted to make you aware of the SAP BTP guidance framework. You might already know about the SAP BTP developer's guide. Well, think of the guidance framework as sort of one level up from that, something that contains the SAP BTP developer's guide and lots more. Now, the aim of this framework is to provide architects and administrators, as well as developers, all they need to know to build and run and maintain enterprise-grade and enterprise-scale applications and solutions on SAP BTP. We've included a link to the sort of landing page to the guidance framework, which is on the SAP Help Portal. And from there, you have links to all the individual components. Happy learning!